Welcome to Sailing Yacht MV YouTube channel. Above the Sailing Yacht MV, we go to talk one moment about valve and through hole. Normally, the most of the yacht, they install the normal style, bronze, with the ball and stainless steel. This kind of through hole in bronze, they are very reliable for many years. Only this kind of through hole and valve is installed for the most in the most of the yacht. The only thing you have to keep in watch the quality of the bronze, and when the bronze starts to come in red, you have to scrub a little bit to check if the porosity of the material starts to making the through hole fragile.
If you scratch the surface of the bronze through hole and notice it looks red underneath, it's a sign that the material has crystallized and it's urgently time to replace it, otherwise it risks to shatter when any force is exerted on it.
Because maybe when you go to open and close the valve, you risk to break the through hole, and after you have one big access to water inside to the hole. This kind of damage, they can make in risk the safety and to the boat, and maybe the boat don't float in anymore. But you can always put one finger or one piece of wood for close the hole. Okay, nothing wrong about this kind of through hole. They are very solid, reliable, 6-10 years. I don't suggest to go over. After is better to, for me, every 6 or 7 years is better to remove and put a new one.
Yeah.
This kind of valve is too heavy for one yacht like a Sailing Yacht MV. The hole to Sailing Yacht MV is in foam, PVC and Termalto. Two layers of fiberglass, interior and exterior. And this foam, also if the high density, like this one, is very hard.
Even though it's high density foam and is very hard, when force is exerted on the through hole, for example when opening and closing the valve, or when the boat bashes into waves, it can cause the valve to move slightly and allow water to enter.
The Sailing Yacht MV is a one height performance boat. The height performance boat, they have one valve through hole. I mean, this valve have no through hole. The through hole is one hole on the hole into the foam.
The through hole in this case is just a hole in the hull with a plastic tube inserted inside.
And the valve is the cork in Teflon or nylon of the valve is made for stay open like this. And like we see, there is the access of water on into the pipe, into the boat. If you see inside, we can see the light, because there is the through hole is ready there. And then when you wanna close, you push down one cork in fibra. You have to go really down. And after, close. And now it's in position safety. And that's it, because the cork got to be in the same shape to the hole. When we cut exactly with the shape of the boat, there is a less friction. And when you wanna open, you turn a little bit when the pin come on the same line. Bam. Going up, you see this pin? This pin is the pin when go in. Go in this teeth here like this, poof, and block the valve. And when you wanna open, tuck, go in single line, bing. And after it's open, if you see, now there is the light, we can see inside, you see, and the cork go down, it's blocked completely. Is a very good valve if you want to go fast. They don't think a lot of about the long life of the boat, because There is no true hole. There is not something protect the foam of the hole. There is not one real system. The only thing when you making the hole, you wet with the microfibra the foam for a seal. It's very nice valve in reality. It's the same one to the Vendée Globe boat or the high performance sailing boat like Ocean Race, but yeah, it's not practical. Another problem they have sometimes that you have some leak of water. If you see here, yeah, there is the sign, this valve always leak a little bit because this shaft have to go in and out and making one access for the water. And also some leak in the hose because this pipe where you fit the hose is very skinny with no any kind of teeth to block properly and seal the hole. Also, if you see, it's glue on the hole up to when it's glue, but if they start to move, it's not one fitting with the real seal. It's very high performance for the sailing yacht, the Duo Regata, because they keep all time close with the cork, close the hole, and when they have to use the toilet, they open, they use it, and after they close again. But for the cruiser, we keep open for a full day, and we close only in the bad weather, it's not very practical. I prefer to lose it some speed, but have one normal cork, one normal valve. Reason why we take the decision, we don't need to reach the maximum speed of the boat. We can go lost a couple of knots, but we want to keep the boat very light and reliable and safety. Reason why we choose the valve in high quality plastic. For the valve, we choose the valve in high quality plastic. The true design marine bulb valve. Very light, super seal. The true hole is in the same quality plastic and fit and seal the hole very well. Like I go to show you on board, we have to prepare the hole. We can't through one hole on the foam and install directly one through hole because for two reasons. One, the foam is not sealed. Second reason, when we tighten maximum the through hole, we can see we compress the foam and we delaminate and we making the access for the water. Reason why we go to prepare one big hole 100 or 200 inside to the hole for restructure the hole and substitution the foam with the hard wood or lamination in fiberglass. And after we close inside to the hole with the lamination in a vacuum of fiberglass. In this system we have the guarantee with our hole is a safety and seal forever. Here from Sailing Yacht MB, Timo, on board to MB, and today I work in the true hole. In MB before there is the five true hole, no one is prepare the foam and the hole with the correct reinforce. Before I have only hole in pure fiberglass, and it's more easy to do one true hole, you can do one lamination in the interior of the hole for reinforce the hole, for distribution the force and the compression of the true hole when you fit it. But in one racing yacht in foam, PVC Termalto, it's not enough to drill and wet with a micro balloon or epoxy the foam for making seal. This is what they do it before. Now, because we have more experience, the yacht industry is already 30 years, we built a boat in foam, we know it's better to do one good preparation. The good preparation, I mean, drill the hole with one big, also 100 or 200 for making the space for the glue, one disc in fiberglass pour,
I mean a stratification of fiberglass on the table, making one disc, how much is high the foam, normally is 1 inch, or in this situation for being more fast, I use the hard wood, mahogany, because it's a good wood we can find in Fiji. There is no hole on crack on the wood. I pre-glue in compression in a vacuum the wood with one layer of carbon, go to rejoint the hole below the foam to the interior hole in fiberglass. Now I start the lamination of fiberglass and few layer of carbon for distribution and close this special structural in wood inside to the hole and guarantee the seal of the foam. In any kind of case, when I go to drill the true hole, here is one small true hole, a 1/3 inch for intake water maker, I don't have the worry the humidity from the wood go to pass inside to the foam. And also give me one structure, because this nut in wood is in prison inside to the hole, go to give me one big strong structure for tight maximum I want my true hole, and the valve also when I have some elasticity, some play, don't risk to crack and making the water line, the infiltration for the water inside to the foam.
This diagram shows the steps taken to correctly prepare a through hole. Step 1 shows the hull composition, which is the foam in yellow sandwiched between two layers of fiberglass in blue. Step 2 shows a hole being drilled through the interior layer of fiberglass and the foam. Step 3 shows a lamination of a layer of fiberglass or carbon around the inside wall of the hole. This connects the inner and outer layers of fiberglass and seals off the foam. Step 4 is gluing in the new plug made of fiberglass or wood, shown in brown in this diagram. And step 5 is laminating on top of this plug. Then in the final step, 6, we drill through everything and insert the through hole.
Now, we are ready. You see my disc with the plastic and all lamination. Perfect.
If you want to see more of Timo's laminating and vacuum bagging techniques, stay tuned for a future video where we'll go through the process in detail and show you some tricks.
The carbon I got to put below, and my valve vacuum pump is here. Thank you so much from Sailing Yacht NV. Remember to watch our channel, Sailing NV YouTube. Subscribe, because you help us to making this a big challenger and sailing with you in the future. Ciao. I have to say thank you to two important reference for information and teaching about fiberglass, because he's very expert professional guys. Is one is Luciano Massano, and the other one is Mr. Pillo from Roma Fiumicino.
Both they have a high quality professional experience in a vacuum and both building in carbon fiber. It's two different people. From Pillo, I learn how can prepare correct one all in foam. Since Tyrion è interior e exterior. The truth is one hole on the hole, hole on the hole, hole on the hole.